Hey, what up, though? The big homie Juice, and you watching Takeover TV, the best show in America. Believe that.
I want to ask you about this, some Lobo stuff.
Lobo,
Lobo stuff. Spence and Ricardo did what? Top 100 recently, right?
Yep.
Where they put you at?
Man, that nigga gave me Sean Kemp, man. Got shit going on in here, man. Spence and Ricardo, they gave me 40.
So you had 40.
Now, say this. From 2000, what it's like about 80 people on a team.
Yeah.
So if I times that by, what, 20 years, what's that, 1,600 players?
Yeah.
So, like, it's like 40 out of 1,600.
Ain't too bad, man. Once you think about it, once you broke it down like that.
Yeah, when I think about it, for somebody who, I didn't play Little League football, I played 1 year in middle school. The next year, I broke my collarbone playing quarterback.
Yeah.
And she, the only reason I really wanted to play, because I didn't want to look like no old goofy ass nigga. You know them niggas that don't play with the jersey over the collar shirt?
Yeah, like collar that, shirt. That type shit.
Yeah, nigga, you over there like holding water for niggas.
So you good at 40? Or you think you should be a little higher?
I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna be good. Because I respect the players that came in front of me.
Exactly.
You see what I'm saying? So I respect every player that came in. I respect their opinion.
Yeah.
My opinion, personally? Yeah, I feel like when I could have been a little bit high. When I seen the other player, I like, well, I think I made a little impact like them. You know what I'm saying? It's just for me.
Yeah.
You got to understand, you got to put in context, like, I was like the six option on the offense. It, like, I played for damn near Eric Crouch offense. You know what I'm saying? It was basically that. You know what I'm saying? So, to do what I did, I just say it like this. A college recruiting coach gonna know. You know what I'm saying? I got all my D1 offers after my junior year. They had already seen. My senior year, I had better numbers. Shit. I ain't getting number like one more D1 offer. It's about what they see. They can tell if you can play or not.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I think as far as my skill set and what I used to do, I'm pretty straight. I think people don't take it serious because me, I don't seem like no football player. You know what I'm saying?
I seen you play.
Huh?
I mean, I seen you play, so.
I was straight.
I was okay.
But yeah, nah.
So okay, let's go to the.
Oh, shit.
Oh man, that thing made a steal. It'd be all right.
That bitch durable like a motherfucker.
You know how many times that thing been dropped?
Shit, I don't care, boy. You break your body. Shit.
So, where would you rank yourself as far as Lobo receivers?
Lobo receiver? I put Camden in front of me, and I put Michael Kelly in front of me. And that's it.
You know what?
For me.
I'm going to be honest with you.
Personally.
I had you third.
Okay, that's cool.
I had you third.
I appreciate it. But that ain't no disrespect to nobody.
That ain't no disrespect. That ain't no disrespect.
D Rob, TB, Eric Hawkins. You know what I'm saying?
Because I had. Dorian. I had Camden 1 and Malcolm 2. People like, man, how the hell did. Hey, when the big games came.
They gonna make plays.
They gonna make plays. You can flip them if you want.
Reggie Wayne.
Yeah.
Malcolm Kelly remind me of Megatron. And I feel like I was more like a Chad Johnson. Like in that box, I used to love that shit in one-on-ones.
Yeah.
Like when somebody read in front of me. Cause it's like basketball, you get to travel without the ball. So I get to cross this dude up and I ain't got a dribble or nothing. So I'm in this box and I'm just, you know what I'm saying? It's our peanut butter. He trying to jam.
Well, let me ask you this, man.
Yeah.
In 2008, when y'all was playing, was that Dallas Carter?
Mm-hmm.
Up there in Corsicana.
Mm-hmm.
What was y'all thinking, man, when they was out there in the middle of the field talking that shit to y'all.
You know what?
Did y'all want to go out there?
To be honest, I tell this story all the time. There was the year Friday Night Lights came up. And you know, at the end, Dallas Carter was them motherfuckers.
Mm-hmm.
And they was on our schedule. So this is like my first real year playing real football. I played like a game on varsity. Matter of fact, I played against Dallas Carter the year before. But
I'm talking about the playoff game.
The playoffs. Yeah. That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
When I seen them coming, stretching, I was stretching. I was in squatting the woods, and all I seen was a shadow. And I looked up, big ass niggas. I was like, damn, these Dallas Carter niggas big as fuck. I was like, god damn. I said, we finna go out in third round on these hoe ass niggas. And I was like, but then we started playing. Then they came, but one thing about Longview niggas, like, we can be chill as you want, but you can't, like, poke us. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can't.
Like Tessa Cavalier. Yeah,
exactly. Like, you can't, we'll be chill, but you can't fuck with us. Like, right. Just don't push us. Cause then go like, all right, fuck it. We're gonna take it out of the way there. Let's go. So then when they did that shit, I remember that nigga King got us together.
Yeah.
And I don't know what the fuck he was saying, but it was spit coming out and niggas started getting crumpled. My dumb ass trying to get up in there like, yeah, yeah, yeah. Niggas was hype, but that's what I say, like, that shit was hype, but we just went out there. I was like, oh, these niggas sorry.
I'm gonna tell you something. By the time me and my homeboy and them got to the game, right? Homeboy side sold out.
Oh, yeah.
So we had to go sit on the Dallas Carter side. Ooh. Over there. So they came out, yeah, we've been to beat these niggas and all that shit.
Mm-hmm.
We wanted to talk some shit. We like, man, there's too many niggas over there.
Right, right.
So we just kind of like.
Jurisdiction.
We like, shit.
Yeah.
And then the people behind us like, man, we gonna beat them by 20. They can't do nothing but run the ball.
Hmm.
I'm like, y'all, these niggas ain't seen those plays. So, you know, we were chilling. Yeah. We were chilling. As the game went on, like, man, these niggas way better than we
That's how it went.
They like, shit, who is number 10? We can't stop. Man.
You're not stopping Aaron Johnson.
So we up here snickering this shit.
Yeah, that's how it went, bro. Because we never won the get off the bus. Know what I'm saying? Competition. Like, right. You see us got the bus, my skinny ass. Know what I'm saying? Tyler, know what I'm saying? He normal size. Spencer, small ass. You know what I'm saying? But then we get out there, you're like, man, these niggas doggish out here.
Let's fast forward. Mm-hmm. Next game with Waco Midway.
Oh, man.
Y'all going for two. What was y'all thinking? What happened when y'all went to the sideline?
To be honest, I didn't learn football until my junior year in college. So I didn't know the situation. Yeah. I thought we was just gonna keep playing if we didn't make it.
That's the season.
On my mama. And guess what? That play was called, I remember, because the earlier when we beat Lufkin in that 3-overtime that year,
mm-hmm.
And then Coach King called the play for me to go in and win it. I ain't want this shit. I ain't gonna lie. I was that nigga, they changed that shit and gave it to Tyler. I was happy to the bitch. I was like, hell yeah.
No.
I'ma let them real football players have that shit.
Yeah.
So when we went out there, all I can remember, and you can see it on the camera, I remember that nigga Spencer was just waving the towel. I was like, man, this nigga extra crunk for this little play. I'm like, we finna keep playing. I didn't know what overtime we was in. I didn't know shit. I used to be just after playing, I didn't know nothing. I come from hooping. I was just out there bullshitting. So when I was out there, and I see the play go down, I'm right there. I see head barely get across. And shit, he go up like this. And I swear to God, on my mama, I didn't know the game was over.
She saw the whole.
Until I was at the bottom of a goddamn pile, I couldn't breathe. It wasn't no Damian Lillard. That when Damian was on that hole.
Yeah, you can see it. He could still breathe.
I couldn't breathe. Like, I was getting killed under there. If you look on that play, you see a big pal.
Yeah.
Hey, I was under that hole. I ain't never, but I'm gonna suffocate. That was the livest shit I ever been a part of, though.
For some reason, I couldn't make it to that game. I was listening to the radio.
That shit.
You know, that's the famous call right there.
Yeah.
Man, we all sitting at the edge of the couch.
Yes, he did. Because
they like, he's good. All right, this for the season. I'm like, these fuckers going for two.
For two, bro. What was it? 43-42. One of them.
Aaron got the ball to keep her, and he paused. Like, what the fuck happened? Then he started screaming. Man. I thought he didn't make it. I thought he was mad. But then he's like, yes, he did. I'm like, oh, they won. God
man,
damn, they won.
Man, that's probably one of the greatest plays ever, man. Like,
dude.
And we was in there, like.
In one play, that's probably the most suspenseful, exciting play.
That's why I tell everybody.
That's the season.
Like, we might not to people been the most, the best team, the most talented team, but I can say this, I vouch for this. And people still say this. We had the most entertaining team. You didn't know what the fuck you were gonna see. We might barely beat Texas High. We might barely beat Hinesville. We blow ourselves a spring. We might be losing to Allen by fucking 17 points and come back and beat their ass.
Oh, that was classic.
We might be losing to Lufkin by 20 and come back and beat them.
Another classic game.
We might be losing to fucking Waxahachie by 21 and roll out 50 straight on their ass. Like, we were just like that, bro. Just.
So, we're going to move to the next game.
Yeah.
I played Denton. You caught the long touchdown pass.
Yeah. That boy head was dropping them hoes like butter.
Oh, man. He was slanging them.
Yeah, he was. He was on.
He had a damn good game that
game. That was a magical night, man. That night right there got me out of my Johnson scholarship.
Ran to one side of the field, back to the other side of the field, and cut. I was there for that.
Yeah, that shit was crazy. He was on that game. It was like watching if you was on the field with him that game, because he is so calm, he just a calm dude. It was like when people say they seen Jordan and he had a little shine to him.
Yeah.
It was out there just, it was like he was glowing, like that nigga was in a zone.
Aaron Judge reminded me of Vince Young.
Yo.
The stride and how he could just.
He an ultimate leader. He always been, I always called him Captain America. Couldn't do no wrong. In school, that motherfucker used to wear Under Armour and some army pants, no uniform. My partners, one we wear uniforms, they get put off the motherfucking the other school, date and shit.
Yeah.
Hey, that nigga walking around with an Under Armour. That's Captain America.
And then we move to the state championship game.
Which one? They both hurt.
The first one.
Oh yeah, that was tough.
You got hurt. Tyler got hurt.
I know, it was fluky.
So what was y'all mentality going into the game? Knowing they had the Gatorade Player of the Year on the other side.
Didn't have no clue. Like, for me, I ain't gonna lie, I never watched film. I don't know who we were playing, never. Like, in the film room, we used to watch film, I used to be on my phone. Like, I never knew what our opponent was, cause I always thought, like, shit, we got the players. Like, I don't know what they got going.
Except for these boys, yeah.
I just seen, like, when Tyler got hurt, and then, shit, I just got hurt on some fluky shit. Like, I caught a hitch,
mm-hmm.
and, like, my ankle rolled up, and I just, see, I started trying to, like, get, like, put pressure on. I couldn't. I was out, and I was like, damn, these niggas ain't got me or Tyler. And me and him both on crutches, and I feel hopeless.
And you got this damn juggernaut over here. That.
And I ain't never seen that many people. Like, yeah. it was a tight feeling when I'm looking back. I'm like, damn, boy.
Stands.
I'm like, damn, man, we got all these four people. So you felt like it was a letdown, but we always thought, like, damn, we done got this far. We didn't even know we was this good. Like, I can remember talking to Vinny before we went to the state game after then. God, we was, it was when everybody was gone from the stadium. We was just went back out to the field to wait for the buses. Me and Vinny were like, bro, we really going to the state championship? Like, me and him was on JV together the year before, riding five deep back to the south in goddamn Mitsubishi Mirage.
Right.
Like, just bullshit. Like, we didn't give a fuck. Like, now we out here like, damn. We ain't know shit, but the next year that shit was fucked up though. I ain't never watched neither one of them games.
I wouldn't need them.
I can't. I'm like Jalen Rose.
Was it worse the second year or the first year?
The second year.
Oh yeah, because that's your last year.
Man, I was probably like 25% that game, but you were gonna have to kill me, get me out there for you. Cause
it was cold that night too.
It was tough, man. Cause it like, it was deja vu. Cause now me and Tyler done got hurt. I got horse collar the quarterfinals. Tyler got hurt the cause your ankle and them bones, once it get colder, started messing. He got a whole bone spur in his ankle. So it's like,
same.
He got a whole screw, I mean. So it was the same thing. We both, you know what I'm saying, ankle injuries going into the game. I'm like, damn, man, this shit can't be real. So I tried to, you know what I'm saying, do as best I can to get ready, but man, I swear, I had tears in my eyes in that game because I couldn't. I remember catching a bubble and I had nothing but a safety. And if I was just 75%, that's half sky. I feel giving some juice and we gone. Man, all I could do is run straight and try to run them over. I ain't never trucked nobody in my life. I was just crying while I'm running with the ball because I was dead mad. It was just like that, man. Then we had fluky stuff, kickoff, you know, they dropped the kick, you know what I'm saying? And they recovered on their 20. We get a fumble on their 20. They get the ball on their own 20 two times. They only won 24-17. It's that little shit.
Yeah.
And that's what hurt, because you be like, man, we way more talented than that team. It's just that, and then also, you feel like you let down your people. Then you know, shit, you ain't gonna never play with these boys again.
Never again, that's it.
That's the tightest I ever been with a group of people is that year. Cause college is business.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And yeah, right. We was cliqued up in high school, but that's the tightest you gonna ever be with a team is your senior year. You right. know what I'm saying? Then when I seen Head crying and shit, Head don't cry at all. That nigga broke, I accidentally undercut him hooping, and nigga broke his knee. Nigga was kind of sniffling. But for a broke knee, that nigga was, and this when we were younger. So when he came, that nigga held it together. I seen the nigga over there in that corner crying. I was like, damn, oh, this shit over. This shit really over.
That's it.
Then you take that jersey off and you throw that hoe in that pad for the last time, you would look at that bitch and be like, damn, what the fuck am I now? When you done played football for the Lobos and you, that's part of you, and you done put, nigga like me, I left it all on the field. I always did. I played my whole senior year in college with hernias. That's why I had to get a hernia surgery after. Mm-hmm. I played a whole year with that shit. I leave it on the field. You ain't gonna get shit out of me during practice. But shit, when them lights come on, I'ma leave it after.
Allen Iverson, huh?
I got practice. Practice? Oh, nah, you ain't getting shit out. Man, in high school, I used to come to practice late sometimes because I had to get my cut. Yeah, I got to be fresh for Friday. Them barbers don't give a fuck. They try to go home. And if we watch a film on Thursday to 7 o'clock, we got practice Wednesday. Okay, so shit, hey, I'm going to meet y'all on that bottom field one practice.
Man, what you, I saw Spence there post something about the 05 team versus the 08 team. Mm-hmm. Who will win? I already know what you going to say.
Yeah. He's like, we ain't got to say it. We already know who I'm riding with. No disrespect to their team, though. The boys was some dogs.
That would be a classic ass game.
Mm-hmm. Because I feel like everything they got, we got too. You got a dynamic receiver, we got a dynamic receiver. You got a dynamic running back, we got a dynamic running back.
Hell, they actually got two with Chris.
We do too.
Oh, yeah, you do.
You see what I'm saying? Like, and we got a running quarterback, a dual threat. Carlin was good, too, though. No disrespect to him.
Yeah, now, Carlin was good.
On defense, you know, they had fucking dogs. But Eddie is the most smallest ball of fire you're going to ever meet on that field.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? We had Tay, we had Boo, we had Bubba. Like, we had dogs, man. Like, so I feel like it would just been a good game. Still got the same coach. Still the coach is offset. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm kick returning, number 3. Vondrell kick returning, number 3. Toss it up. That's all I say. They be like 5'8", this, that. I get it. They was. They did. I keep telling them, hey, you gonna tell me about me not winning in 4A? I'm gonna tell you lost that first rounder.
Man, I was sick.
You? I ain't even pay attention to football back then, but I knew something wasn't right. I was like, nah, it's too early. It's still kind of hot outside, and they lost.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, it ain't even cold yet. I know Lobo playoff shit. It be cold when we lose.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, it was
still warm. Yeah.
It was real windy that day. I remember that.
It was.
It was in Mesquite. I remember that. And I remember seeing the boys crying on the field. I mean, when they were coming out, I was like, damn, these boys hurt. I was like,
ain't no way the way it's supposed to lose that game.
Nah.
Everybody was looking forward to the rematch at SFA with Lufkin.
See, hey, that game the year before.
They should have lost that one.
That's what made me, like, I was always in Coach Martin basketball camps going David Whisk. I was a hooper. So when I went to that game with Chris Knight and Thomas Knight, we came and we had to park way out there.
Man, so many people.
We came to that game. I said, man, this is what football is. I said, man, shit, I kind of, shit kind of fun. I need some of this.
I ain't never been to no playoff game like that, except for the state final, in 2018.
Yeah, now that shit was live. I was so happy.
Oh, man.
I was so happy. I was like, God damn, finally, dude. Man. And to see King and, man, Coach King, man, deserved it.
I had so much emotion for that game. I was actually physically sick when the game was over.
I ain't gonna lie. It was a nervous feeling in that fourth quarter. I was like,
I'm like, man, we can't lose again.
Nah, not in front of these people.
I'm like, man, not come on. I'm like, man, we do, man, come.
Cause it ain't nothing worse than waking up in the morning after losing another, and you see, I say, oh, Dangerfield won. Oh, Carthage
won for the 20th time.
Yeah. I said, Gilmore won. I said, then here we go over here. They had me in that hoe hugging somebody, crying like a little hoe. I said, man, they ain't have to put that picture up in that hoe.
Longview couldn't lose that 2018 game because we did all that damn video footage and shit. Hey, I was like, fuck, we got to delete all this shit if they lose.
When I say that was Longview was partying in that goddamn parking lot, we just knew we were at war before the time. That was good times though, man. I was so proud of them boys. I was so happy, man. Them coaches.
For everybody ever put on the Lobo jersey.
Longview needed that win. We've been taking, Longview as a city, been taking losses for a while.
And the worst losses. Yeah. Field goals missed, fumbles, block punts, and
man,
all kind of
just
shit.
Just our
man.
Type of heartbreak. And our type of great players done came through. And people be like, ah, he ain't got a chip, and they ain't won. I'll be like, we played the biggest motherfuckers out of the cities.
Yeah.
We're not playing places where the Dairy Queen popping. We're not playing new small towns in these state championships. Right. Late Travis go after them. See what that money look like.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Look at that weight room. You'll know. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. But tell me this, though.
Okay.
As far as what you done seen from when you was in high school and then now for how football look, do you think it's better for the kids to have this much exposure this early? Or you think it was better like how it was when we were coming up? Cause I be seeing a lot of kids, they already get the college, like Texas, for example. They get all them five-star recruits that been on these TV shows and Spencer Rattler at Oklahoma.
Mm-hmm.
You don't put him on his TV show, he might feel like he already obligated to be the star. I think that if they just let them boys just play in high school, get the regular recruitment, I think that teams like that, players like that would be better out. Cause it seems like it'd be like the players you didn't even know was gonna be called that seemed like come up out the rank, like Lamar Jackson. He wasn't really highly recruited. The ones that been highly recruited the last couple years, I don't really see them panning out like that lately. I hope Haynes King do though.
Yeah.
But how was it back when y'all day? Like, how did they recruit? Like,
old school. You had to come to the game. You know what I'm saying? Wasn't no social media.
Right.
And then you got that, man, it was so tough back then because only two teams out the district was going. It wasn't no four team stuff. There wasn't no small school, big school. It was just
straight up.
Just straight 5A.
Okay. Yeah.
So that shit, man.
Yeah, that shit tough. That shit weird.
Back in my days, it's like if you played Lobo football from Pee Wee all the way up, if you weren't a running back or played defense, you just a blocker.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You just a blocker. Man. So now I'm glad that it evolved because now more people are getting opportunities, your tight ends, your wide receivers, you know.
It's just like for me, I see it like, man, I be looking at how far, like, even Longview football came, and I see them out there in Adidas and stuff, and all that. I just see, I'll be like, man.
I know.
We used to have them grays and them dirty ass girdles, and who fuck stole my socks off my goddamn clip?
I don't know. I mean,